Reverend Peter Lawrence, OIM, CEO of the ASC, Mr. Mike Noble, Chair of School Council, staff, students, parents and friends watching online. Welcome to this afternoon's 2020 presentation ceremony. Please be seated. We begin this afternoon's ceremony, as is tradition at Cathedral College, with the commissioning of our 2021 school captains. I would ask our 2020 school captains to please join us on stage, and our 2021 school captains, Henry and Tess. Henry and Tess, do you promise to support and work with your principal, staff and students in representing the school and in activities to the best of your abilities?
I do.
Will you endeavour to attend all required meetings, events and additional activities which may be required of you in your position of responsibility?
I do.
Will you ensure that you will lead your school by example and work to foster a spirit of commitment across Cathedral College in support of the principal?
I will.
Will you endeavour to promote the school's values in everything you do, abiding by school rules, taking part in college activities, and encouraging others to do likewise?
I will.
I now commission you as school captains for 2021. May you remember your responsibilities faithfully, even as you enjoy opportunities this position may provide. Would you please congratulate us?
The acknowledgement of country. In acknowledging the country in which Cathedral College Wangaratta stands, Albury, young children, Kogamilga, children in general, and Uthu, me, the person reading, we'd like to give thanks to Biyana, the creator, for all that is around us. We would also like to take this opportunity to acknowledge our totem, Nagu or Koala, for looking over us as we go into each day with truth and service guiding our journey. Dirawara, together, we acknowledge other Namungan, clan members from the same country or family, and Kuris, Aboriginal person, present here today. Dirawara, together, we acknowledge the bravery of past, present, and emerging Aboriginal and the Pangarang peoples. Now please stand for the National Anthem and remain standing for the College of Pleasure.
I'm
Lord's Prayer, God our Father.
Who art so soul is sanctuary, we ask a blessing upon all your teach and all the name of the people. Our life is the victory, and it is the truth of our life, and it is the sin of the world. Amen.
Please be seated. We now welcome our principal, Mr. Nick Jones, to deliver the principal's address for 2021.
Thank you, Tess. Well, can you believe it? We have come to the end of an extraordinary year, and we are gathering together in the stadium today for the first time since February. That's been about 270 days. If someone had sat you down at the beginning of 2020 and told you everything that was going to happen this year, I'm sure you would have looked at them like they were crazy. Firstly, they would have explained that the raging bushfires, dangerous bushfires, were about to rage across the northeast of Victoria, causing thousands of square kilometres of land to burn, and many families, some of them here today, requiring to evacuate their homes. They would then explain that a highly infectious virus would sweep across the globe, causing mass lockdowns, the cancellation of sport, art, music, and many other important community events. And finally, we would be required to shut down our schools, and the term remote learning would become a very real thing. I don't know about you, but if someone had described all this to me at the start of the year, I definitely would not have believed them. However, all this has happened this year, and as we sit here today, you should reflect on what we have experienced in 2020 and be very proud of everything we have achieved together. If this year has taught you anything, it must be that you are braver, stronger, and more courageous than you ever knew. You have made it through one of the most challenging years ever, and the resilience, flexibility, and adaptability you have shown will put you in good stead with the years ahead of you. You now know with confidence that you can face any challenge that gets put in front of you and get through it. Because if 2020 hasn't broken you, nothing will. It is widely acknowledged that the characteristic of resilience is a crucial factor in achieving success in life. A simple definition of resilience is the ability to recover or bounce back from difficulties. Our head of junior school, Mr. Newbold, explains that resilience is like a rubber ball that returns to its normal state after being bounced or thrown against the wall. I think this is a really great analogy. However, I would go a step further and suggest that successfully rebounding from adversity does not just mean returning to how we were, it allows us to be even stronger. Resilience is not a skill that you can develop by reading about it in a textbook or watching other people be resilient. True resiliency can only be developed through lived experience, actually practicing the skill of resilience. This year, you've had no choice. The reality of life is that there will be challenges placed in front of you. I hope that we never have to live through a year like this one. However, you will face adversity in life, you will experience disappointment, and you will experience failure in your life. What you've learned about yourself this year is that you have everything you need within you to bounce back from disappointment and adversity and achieve anything you set your mind to. Having successfully navigated the challenges of 2020, you should look forward with confidence that you can overcome any obstacle that comes your way. The next lesson we have been reminded of this year is the true value and importance of the community in which we live. I have no doubt that we have successfully made it through this very tough year because of the strength and the connectedness of our school community. You, our students, have been supported by extremely dedicated and professional teachers and support staff who have gone above and beyond to ensure that your high-quality lessons and learning experiences were delivered each day during our periods of remote learning. To all our teachers and support staff, I say thank you. You also received great support from your parents, family, and friends during this difficult time. to our parents and family who supervised and assisted their children while also being required to work from home, I say thank you. This year, more than ever, you have been asked to be a parent, a teacher, a counsellor, a friend, a confidant. Well done, and I thank you. So now we look forward to 2021, looking forward with an understanding of the importance of appreciating all that we have here at our great school. And we will never again take for granted the opportunity to gather together, to learn, to play, to laugh, and to grow. So as we say goodbye to 2020, we look forward next year when we'll again return to our whole school assemblies, to our school productions and other musical events, drama, our inter-school and community sporting events, to inviting parents, family and friends back to our campus, to our camps and excursions, and to all the other great things that make school fun. To the small number of students and staff who are moving on to a different school or new opportunities next year, I thank you for your contribution to Cathedral College, and we wish you the very best of luck for your new adventures. Finally, I would like to acknowledge and thank our Chair of School Council, Mr. Mike Noble. Mike is retiring from his position after more than 12 years in the role. From all of us at Cathedral College, we sincerely thank Mike for his leadership, commitment, and dedication to the college. Mike has invested thousands of hours to the role of Chair of School Council, and we are forever grateful for his contributions to the development and success of the college. We look forward to current Deputy Chair of Council, Mrs. Victoria Mallander, taking on this important role from the start of next year. And to all our students, staff, parents, family and friends, I would like to wish you a very blessed and holy Christmas and a safe and happy new year. Enjoy the summer break and make the most of the opportunity to come together with family and friends to enjoy each other's company. We have spent way too much time in front of devices and screens this year, so my challenge to you is to put away those Xboxes and put away the PlayStations and spend as much time as you can outside enjoying the summer weather and natural attractions of our northeast region. I look forward to welcoming everyone back to school for the start of 2021 and wish you a very Merry Christmas. All the best. Invite the Reverend Peter Lawrence OAM, CEO of the AFC, to present to the college.
I acknowledge the original owners and custodians of this land on which Cathedral College stands, the Klangarang people. With thankful hearts, may our steps be gentle and respectful of one another. Good afternoon, everyone. To Bishop Clarence, to Chair of Council Mike Noble and members of the College Council, Principal Mr. Nick Jones, to, I normally say special guests, but apart from me, I don't think there are any, so I'll acknowledge myself. And I'll look down the lens of the camera and acknowledge the parents who aren't here, but will no doubt on Boxing Day, when they have nothing else to do, in between Netflix, watch the highlights of this afternoon, and indeed to the staff and students of Cathedral College. It is great to be back in Wangaratta. I had my first interstate flight yesterday afternoon since the hard border between Western Australia and the rest of the world actually came down a week or two ago to allow me to get over here. And it was fun to remember what it's like on an aeroplane again. But it's more fun to be back in this school and see how great it is looking and how you're all looking and actually just make it in time for the very end of the year. Way back in the 1500s, the intrepid English explorer Sir Francis Drake, who circumnavigated the world on a very small ship, declared this: "Disturb us, Lord, when we are too well pleased with ourselves, when our dreams have come true because we have dreamt too little, when we arrive safely because we sailed too close to the shore. Disturb us, Lord, to dare more boldly, to venture on wider seas, where storms will show mastery. Where losing sight of land, we shall find the stars. It was, of course, in 2020 that the Lord did indeed disturb us, made us think who we are, what are our dreams, and which ones could we turn into reality. In a world that's usually safe, secure, and predictable, we've shaken and been shaken by uncertainty. And in being shaken, we found our true self. And by the grace of God, by the wisdom of our leaders here in Victoria and indeed nationally, by the knowledge of our medical scientists and by people just being responsible, we're here today, celebrating happily the end of a remarkable year, albeit in a COVID-safe way with parents a long way away, but us being allowed to gather in the gym. One of my favourite quotes of all times comes from an unlikely source, A.A. Milne's children's book, Winnie the Pooh. Winnie, the lovable bear, was full of insight about human behaviour. We can learn a lot from Winnie the Pooh. Here's what Winnie said to his friend Piglet one day. Promise me, you'll always remember, you are braver than you believe, and stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. 2020 has been a really challenging year for the world, for Australia, for Victoria, for Wangaratta and the Northeast, and of course for Cathedral College. This year, you've had to be braver than you believed you could be. You've had to be stronger than you believed you could be, and you've had to be smarter than you ever imagined, and so have I. It's a great reminder of just what a remarkable community you are part of here at Cathedral College. This year, you've sailed from the shore much further than perhaps you ever expected or wanted to do. And there's a new and better you who emerged from it as a member of this college community. In a minute, awards will be presented, and I do want to congratulate those of you who are award winners today. No doubt you're very proud of what you've achieved in what probably has been the most challenging school years since about 1918. And a few of your teachers look fairly elderly, but I don't think any were teaching back then, indeed, were even alive. And to those who are not receiving an award today, yet who are braver, stronger, and smarter, well done to you also. To the captains who've just been commissioned, and to all of Year 11, who I'm sure aren't actually here today, it is a very special year for you next year, and I do wish you well. I'd like to, on behalf of both myself and the Anglican Schools Commission, take this opportunity to thank every teacher of Cathedral College for your dedication this year. My maths says you've spent somewhere around 70 days, give or take a few, in remote learning during 2020. That's extraordinary. For all that's been achieved in 2020, we've been tested by these extraordinary and trying times, and you've shown just how professional and how dedicated you are. How flexible, how adaptable. You've learned that you can teach from anywhere and to anywhere using technology. Bedrooms, dining rooms, and kitchen tables became classrooms. Who'd have thought when we were in this very gym exactly 12 months ago, at the end of the 2019 school year? I truly appreciate the teaching and support staff of this school for what you have done during 2020. A special thank you to the school's leadership team and to Mr. Jones in his first year as principal of this school, and indeed first year of being a principal. You've had to learn on the run and you've learnt very well and very fast. You've display great energy, great wisdom, and great integrity leading this school in 2020. I thank you for what you've done from the beginning of the bushfires through to just opening up today from COVID-19, or recently from COVID-19 lockdowns. Let me extend in particular a special tribute to the chair of the school council, and that is to Mike Noble, sitting behind me, retiring today after 12 years in the role. We've journeyed together a long way, really the whole of those 12 years, from the days when this college was very small, seriously struggling for enrolments and survival, and in very modest facilities operating at the Close, Cathedral Close, and here on a small patch of land on Murdoch Road. And look where the college is today. And for where we are today, you should take a great pride and also accolades as being a significant player in the process. Your wise and steady governance, Mike, as Chair of Council, has been instrumental in shaping what we know today as Cathedral College Wangaratta. On behalf of all 14 schools within the Anglican Schools Commission, and indeed 16,000 students and staff, I would like to express our sincere thanks to you and have a little gift to present to you on behalf of the Anglican Schools Commission. Who knows what 2021 will bring? Hopefully an effective vaccine for COVID-19 will be rolled out. But whatever it does bring, I encourage you to embrace the year with all your heart and with all your mind and with all your spirit. I too, together with the principal, wish you a happy and holy Christmas, filled with family time, filled with love, and filled with generosity of spirit. In being born into our world, Jesus brought hope for a better world. And if at no other time in 2020, we've learned that our world needs a lot of hope. I pray that for 2021, you may find it is a year filled with much joy, with much hope, and with much healing love. As Winnie the Pooh said to Piglet, "Promise me you'll always remember you are braver than you believe and stronger than you seem and smarter than you think." Thank you and God bless.
I invite Ms. Bridget Perkins to announce the Middle School Faculty Awards to be presented by Reverend Peter Lawrence O'Hare.
Thank you, Henry. Academic awards are awarded to the top performing students in each subject area in each year level. This year, in Year 6, the Art Award, the Humanities Award, the Indonesian Award, and the English Award are awarded to Abigail Lee. Well done, Abby. The Performing Arts Award goes to Mathilde Cattier. The Mathematics Award goes to Tanish Fedela. The Physical Education Award goes to a student who is absent today, and that was Jackson Hewitt. The Science Award goes to Nathan Costa. And the German Award goes to Jemima Pazzini. Awards, we have quite a few, so I'd ask you just to please hold your applause till the end of the group. The Art Award goes to Jasmine Waits. The English and the Indonesian Award goes to Benaya Johns. The Performing Arts Award goes to Charlotte Channon. The Science Award goes to Rain Skippen. The Geography and the German Award goes to Ronya Reynolds. The History Award goes to Sophie Bussell. The Mathematics Award goes to Flynn Carson. The Physical Education Award goes to Elsa Wilkinson. And the Technology Award goes to Mackenzie Clark. Please congratulate Amy. And same as the Year 7 Awards, we have quite a few Year 8, so just please hold your applause till the end of the group. Our Year 8 Art Award goes to Henrietta Bradley. Year 8 English, Geography and Performing Arts Award goes to Ruby Hanlon. Our Indonesian Award goes to Ruby Channel Jarvis. Mathematics Award goes to Austin Rhodes. Science Award goes to Charlotte Roberts. Technology Award to Ben Bernacchi. German Award to Ella Kidd. History to India Rosato. And Physical Education to Xavier Pitts. Please. Senior School, Mrs. Lauren Lee, and Mr. Nick Jones to present the Senior School Faculty Awards.
Okay, it's my pleasure today to announce the Senior School Academic Awards, and again, if we can hold our applause until the end of each year level, that would be great. So our Year 9 Faculty Award winners for Art and Performing Arts is Cameron Timms. For Business Management is Campbell Pell. For English, Science and History is Charlotte Lee. For Geography and German is Thomas Clayton. For Technology is Christina Coxall. For Physical Education, Gabrielle Sinclair. And for Mathematics is Charlotte Falls. Please congratulate us. Now for our Year 10 Faculty Awards. The award for Art goes to Kelly Hirschman. English, Gracie Baston. Mathematics, Geography and German is Alice Kerr. Science is Leah Labrell. History is Erin Stephens. Performing Arts, Kyle Bester. Physical Education, Alexander Pitt. And Technology is Sienna Early. Our Year 11 Faculty Award winners. For English and German, Henry Stevens. Art is Bonnie Creek. English Literature and Psychology, Joy Fan. Maths, Methods and Chemistry, Chloe Royal. General Maths and Outdoor Ed, Kate Davey. For Legal Studies, we have two winners, Brooke Watson. And our second winner also is awarded the History Award, and that is Josh Baer. Geography, Callista Ray Stelling. Health and Human Development, Charlotte Bock. Technology and Business Management, Brody Harris. Our winner for Performing Arts, Ned Taylor, was unable to attend today. Physical Education Award goes to Maddie Naylor. Specialist Mathematics, Cassidy Naylor. The Physics Award goes to Jackson Griffin. And the Biology Award, Alice Kerr. Please congratulate. I now introduce Mrs. Julie Finlay and Mr. Mike Noble to present the Ducks Awards.
It is my pleasure to announce the Ducks as year 6 to 11, which will be presented by Mr. Mike Noble. Now, in order to receive the Ducks Award, it is a prize awarded at each year level. To be eligible for these awards, students must have proven themselves to be most conscientious and diligent in meeting deadlines and in producing work of a consistently high standard. Distinctions are used to calculate these awards. Ducks of Year 6 is Abigail Lee. Ducks of the 7 is Ronnie Reynolds. The Ducks of Year 8 is Ruby Hanlon. The Ducks of Year 9 is Charlotte Lee. The Ducks of Year 10 is Alice Kerr. And the Ducks of Year 11 is Chloe Royal. We would also like to present the Middle School and Senior School Academic Encouragement Awards. These are awards that are presented to students who've worked consistently throughout the year. As the title suggests, these are prizes that are given to encourage the recipients to continue to strive and to give of their best. Merits are used to calculate these awards. Year 6, Jemima Zinn. Year 7 Encouragement Award goes to Benaiah Jones. Year 8 Encouragement Award goes to Xavier Dick. Year 9 Encouragement Award is Thomas Clayton. The 10 Encouragement Award goes to India Fletcher Jackson. And we have equal points awarded to the Year 11 Encouragement Award winners, which are Henry Stevens and Joy Bass. I would now like to introduce Ava Locken, who will play a piece called Where Is My Mind by Frank Black, an arrangement by Maxine Sire. Thank you. Mr. Matt Henderson to come forward to present the Lions Club of Wangaratta Award for Community Service. This award is for a Year 9 student who demonstrated genuine compassion and support for the community. This year's award winner is Thomas Clayton. Mr. Tim Gerrish and Mrs. Kirsty Woods will now join me to present the Wangaratta RSL Scholarship. This scholarship is presented to Year 10 and 11 students for application to their studies and the school community. The Wangaratta RSL Scholarships are provided to assist students who have displayed abilities and initiative to achieve higher standards of academic achievement, who display leadership potential, and who have had a high degree of involvement in a wide range of other school activities. The Year 10 award winners are Catherine Box and Oscar Lilly. Our Year 11 award winners were Felix Kilmaster, who is unable to join us today, and Eliana Curtis.
Mr. Gerrish will remain to present the 2nd 24th Battalion Award. The 2nd 24th Battalion Award is presented to a senior school student who has demonstrated exemplary leadership and citizenship across the college community and the wider community. This year, this award goes to Nicholas Dare. May I now introduce Mr. Mike Noble to deliver his final address to us as the Chairman of the College Council.
Thank God. Reiterate right the earlier welcomes and thank you for those kind words. I think sometimes when you sit there listening to when people say nice things about you, it's kind of akin to when you get some happy birthday too. You know, you're a bit embarrassed. Anyway, congratulations for making it through 2020. What a memorable year it has been. From bushfires to COVID. Many people, including the media, have focused on all the negatives. The daily counts, the borders being closed, the economy, the world, the rule breakers. I've been guilty of this too. Worried about my family, worried about my business and staff and the people that I care about. On Saturday night, we had our staff Christmas party, and one of my business partners asked our team to think about what they'd actually taken from this year's experiences. How have you grown? What new strengths have you developed? What are you grateful for that you once took for granted? I've reflected often this year on how fortunate we are to be at a school, a part of the school system that supports our school community so well. In tough times and times of crisis, your school looks after you. So you've all made it through to the finishing line of the 2020 school year. On behalf of the School Council, I would like to congratulate you all for successfully navigating 2020. I would like to give particular thanks to Mr. Jones and the entire Cathedral College staff. You have been leaders in home learning in our region. Your support of our school community was outstanding. I said earlier this morning that I come from a family of teachers. I know how hard teachers work, and I'm sure many of the families and parents with home learning would fully agree after this year. This is my final time speaking as Chair of the School Council. Victoria Mallington takes over from me next year, which is nice because I took over from her mother, Gillian, and she can have this 40-year-old head and wool academic gown to take over. The reason why I started in this role, in hindsight I've mentioned in a speech recently, was probably for selfish reasons. I ran a legal practice and we found it very hard to get young professionals or attract young professionals to the region. So I thought if we had a good local independent school, it would be an attractor for young professionals and a general attractor for other employers looking for employees. I think we've achieved that. But probably what I didn't realise is the community that we've built, which in hindsight is far more important. I couldn't find any of my earlier speeches pre-2010, but on a stick I found my 2010 speech. And I spoke about the opening of the 4, 5 and 6 classrooms, the stage 1 of the library. I can't remember what stage 1 of the library was. It might have been a portable or an old science lab that we carted in from the close out to here. I spoke about fee reduction. I spoke about a move to one campus, which was very controversial at the time. I also spoke about a bit from Peter Lawrence, who'd been over here in his role as a consultant to give us advice on how to make our school sustainable, which it certainly is. So my journey almost started with Peter and ends with Peter today. I'm grateful that he can be here with us today and could cross several borders to do so. He's been a great friend to me, a great friend to our school, and I've learned a lot about leadership from Peter. I'd also like to acknowledge the School Council and many wonderful people that I've worked with over 12 years. In particular, Barb Thomas, who also retires at the end of this year, and she's actually been with the School Council for longer than I, which is a massive undertaking. It's free, takes up a lot of time, but they're all people that are motivated by the good to look after all of you. I'd also like to acknowledge Bishop Clarence, and I mentioned earlier today that it's probably been a bit unfortunate for Bishop Clarence that he hasn't got to know a lot of you as well as in front of this year, but there certainly will over the next few years. Mr. Jones, COVID's probably tested anyone in a leadership position, and particularly if you're a new leader coming into a new organisation. And what we've witnessed with remote learning and the school and how well it's gone, it's a credit to you, Mr. Jones. I think we've probably agreed on one thing this year, he being a WA football follower, me being a Tigers supporter, but how great it was having a grand final in Queensland with two Victorian teams. I've met so many wonderful people during my time, too many to thank individually. You know who you are. Thank you. At a special dinner a few weeks ago, I was given the opportunity to speak about my time as chair of the school council. One word came to mind to summarise my journey: pride. I'm proud with what we've all created together. I'm proud to be Cathedral. Have a great Christmas.
I think 12 years is a very good effort from Mr. Nubble. So can you put your hands together again for him? Well, we present the Quong Lee Dow Young Scholars Program Award, and that goes to is an academic enrichment award awarded by the University of Melbourne, and it's designed to support high achieving Victorian students. And the recipient of that is Alice Kerr. I'll ask Mr. Rod Dunbar to come forward as we present the North East Tracks Local Learning and Employment Network Award. And that's presented to a student who is undertaking a TAFE or VET course with success or making a strong contribution to life at the school. This award goes to Emily Mackesy. Mrs. Woods is going to come forward as she helps me present the Zonta Scholarship. The scholarship is presented to a Year 10 female student entering Year 11 and is based on academic achievement, organisation and contribution. This award goes to Daisy Kendall. Mr. Adam Graham is going to join me on stage now to help me present the Rotary Club of Millwood and Oxley Community Service Award. This award is for students who demonstrate genuine compassion and support for the community. This award goes to Taylor Baldock. I'll ask Mr. Tim Gerrish to join me on stage as he presents the Eric Van Leeuwen Scholarship. The scholarship is awarded to a student who has contributed across a wide variety of areas of the school and the community. And that award goes to Isabella Bridgman. The Rotary Club of Appin Park has a Wangaratta Leadership Award and it's presented to a current Year 10 student to assist them with their Year 11 studies in 2021. That award goes to George McConnell. So we'll pick that award when the morning returns. Miss Julie Finlay is going to join me on stage for the Edgar's Book and News Visual Arts Studies Award. And it's an award for the most outstanding student in Year 12 Visual Arts Studies. That award goes to Zoe Davis. Now, I'm stretching this out a little bit, and there's only one reason. I need Mr. Tim Gerrish to get back to the stage. And he is just coming into that final corner and is making his way towards it. The Ian MacDonald Agriculture and Horticultural Memorial Award is sponsored by the Wangaratta Technical College, class of 1959-60, and it is presented in recognition of their teacher and mentor, Mr. Ian MacDonald. The award is for students or a student who have shown excellence and dedication across their agricultural and horticultural studies. This award goes to Michael Twitchett. And I'll ask Miss Lee to come forward as we present the Charles Sturt University Wangaratta Regional Study Centre Academic Encouragement Award. This award is aimed at increasing the aspirations and capacity of students to participate in tertiary education.
This year that award goes to Jesse Ellis. And I'll invite Reverend Jones to the stage.
I'd now like to invite the Right Reverend Clarence Bester to present the next four awards. The first one is the Dean's Middle School Christian Leadership Award, presented to a student who has done much to promote Christian values and fellowship within the middle school. And this year it goes to Yaz Melendonca. The next one is the Dean's Senior School Christian Leadership Award, awarded to a student who has promoted Christian values and fellowship within the senior school. And this year goes to Mitchell Harris. The next one is the Bishop of Wangaratta's Middle School Award. And this award is presented to a middle school student who has made the most of their opportunities throughout their middle school career. And this year it's awarded to Bridget Zinn. And finally, the Bishop of Wangaratta's Senior School Award, presented to a senior school student who has made the most of their opportunities throughout their senior school. And this year it's awarded to Phoebe Greenway.
Are called the Principals Awards, and they will be presented by Mr. Nick Jones, the Principal. The first Principals Award is for Senior School and Outstanding Contribution to Sport. Unfortunately, the recipient, Max Handball, cannot be here today, but we can still give them a round of applause. The second Principals Award for Outstanding Contributions to College Life go to Lachlan Safern and Laura McKinnon. The next Principals Award are for Middle School Leadership, and they go to Ruby Hanlon and Lachlan Thompson. Principals Award for Senior School Outstanding Leadership within the College Community goes to our 2020 school captains, Lily Mullins and Kyron Hayes.
We would like to introduce a short video in reflection of 2020 produced by Ms. Cantos.
I'm a one-way motorway. I'm a road that drives away. Follows you back home. I'm a street light shining. I'm a white light blind and bright, burning off and on. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give. Times like these, you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. I upon tonight. It's time.
I'd like to invite the Bishop of Wangaratta, the Right Reverend Clarence Best, to give a Christmas blessing.
Can you please stand? May the spirit of Christmas bring love, joy, hope, and peace. May the lights of Christmas light up our lives so that we might be a light and a blessing to others. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you always. Amen.
Please remain standing as the official party departs the stadium.